Last week, the business and political elite gathered in Davos for the World Economic Forum. Certainly, these men and women have achieved positions of prominent power, but you might wonder, how many of them are actually trained and competent leaders? There is a concept in management called the Peter Principle, which argues that in a business hierarchy, people tend to rise to their level of incompetence. Employees who excel in their role get promoted and given new responsibilities, until they are no longer competent, as different job skills don't always translate. This principle is one reason why workers end up with bad managers. People who are skilled in their particular role, from teachers to software engineers, get promoted to management level, but that doesn't mean they have any management skills. Now apply this to business executives. Many don't receive any leadership training until after they have reached positions of leadership, at which point it might be too late. Would it not be better to instead teach these skills to younger talent? That's what Elke Edwards, founder and creative director of corporate training provider Ivy House, believes. "We're taking the best educated generation that we've ever had, who are different from my generation for lots of reasons, and we're taking them down exactly the same path, the path that delivered the leaders we have today, who often don't have the competence or character skills to do the job in front of them," she says. Ivy House has set about trying to change the path of leadership development. The City A.M. features desk is inundated with books promising advice on business leadership that are full of dubious cliches. Edwards is keen to debunk some of the myths. One is that leaders are born, not made. "That's absolute rubbish. We all have a leader within us," she explains. "Leaders are made. But if we leave it until they're 35 or 45 to start making them, they already have a whole load of neural pathways that are fully formed and based on what they've had role modeled for them." Edwards is talking from experience. She's spent the majority of her career in corporate training. She was also a founder of the executive development company Blue Sky in 1997, which she helped run for 18 years. It was eventually acquired by Capita in 2013. Blue Sky grew out of a performance improvement business and became an executive coaching company. "We worked with 45% of the FTSE 100 and won multiple awards for our work," she recalls. "But then I had a moment when I was with a chief executive of a bank, and 20 minutes into the coaching session he said I was crying. I literally had tears running from my eyes and I realized I couldn't do this anymore. If we want to create real change in this country, we need to start sooner, because so many leaders are too invested in their habitual responses and thinking patterns." For more on this story, visit the news article link.